Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. In this video, we are going to talk about reactivity in Svelte. Well, reactivity is a pretty fancy word that means that if you update a variable, it should reflect onto the DOM or your screen. In the previous video, we've seen how we can add dynamic data, define your data in the script tag, and then you can use them in your HTML templates. And today we're going to look at how we can update those data and then get it reflected onto the screen. So over here, I have a count. It says I define a count variable as 0. And I show it on the screen using the curly brackets count over here. And that's it. Right? And I have a button. And this button, what I want to do with this button is I want, when I click on this button, it will increment the counts variable. So we haven't learned about events handlers yet, but let me just type it in and show you that how it's done. We'll talk about them in more details in the next videos. So in this video, just assume that this will add on click so that it increments the count. So how do I increment the variable count? I can do it like how I would do it in JavaScript. I just come over here at count and then I say plus plus. This will increment the count. Will it work? Yes, of course. It will just work like this. So you come here, you increment count, and then it just works. It's like magic. You don't have to do anything else. So what happens over here? Well, actually Svelte will analyze the code, read through all the code, and it will has some sort. It has a sense of what are the variables being used in a template. And these variables is called a state within your components. So this state is only for your components. So the state we have over here is called count. And whenever we try to update the state, Svelte will know as well. So whenever you update the state, Svelte will update the components, updates the elements, and then reflect. Over here, you're using count, right? It will update this element and so that it will reflect the latest value of the count. So now this begs the question, how does Svelte know that I'm updating the state? Well, it tries to analyze the code that you write, but of course it has its limitation. So there's a few things that Svelte looks at and Svelte knows that it's updating the state. So here let me list them what they are. Right, first is assignments. So if you try to assign counts to another variable, so let me remove this for now. Counts equals to 10. This is assignments. You're assigning 10 to count. Svelte knows that this is updating the variable count, right? The state's count. So I click, see 10 appears on the screen. Secondly, let me comment this. Secondly, you can have update statements. Update statements. So what are update statements? Update statements are like this. This is like updating. This is a unary operator that updates a variable. So this works. You can have update assignments. So counts plus equals to 2. Let me comment this. When you click, your plus equals to 2. So plus plus, minus minus, plus equals, times equals, divides equals. Times equals, all these are update statements. Svelte knows that you are updating this variable count. And if count is a state variable, then it knows that it needs to update the component. So let me comment this and let's take a look at the third one, and it's the last one. Updating or assigning a property. So say for example, instead of having count, I have an object. Object equals, and then I'm gonna, this object has a property called count so that I don't have to change too much of my code. So over here in the curly brackets, any JavaScript you can write, so I can write object.count will still works. So here, if I try to update this property, say I try to update it by say object count count plus plus, then this will still works. So how Svelte looks at this statement is that I see you're updating a property of an object. this object, this variable called object. And if this variable is a state variable, right? Again, if this variable is a state variable, in this case it is, then it knows that this is, when you do this, you need to update the components. You have to trigger a component update. Same thing goes with object.count equals to 10. Let me comment this out. If you click, it will update as well. So updates or assignments on property will kickstart that. So anything that falls outside of this three category will not kickstart. The Svelte will not know that you're actually updating the variable, and thus it does not run an update cycle. Which means that you're still able to change the variable, but then it's just not reflected on the screen. So let me get you a few examples. So not an update to Svelte. So first is again we have an object, right? So let's take this example. If an object, if I assign this object to say data, and I come over here data.count plus plus, you would expect that the object count has incremented, right? You would expect that if I click this, you should see, but no, it does not. Why? So Svelte looks at this. Yes, it's an update statement, but this data is not a state. This variable data over here is just a variable within this function. So it has no idea that this data over here is a state. So that's why it does not update the component. So you may ask me like, well, this is obvious, right? Data is equals to object. Yeah, this is obvious in this case, but what if you have another case where data comes from a parameter, something else, right? This is object, you pass by reference, you update this data, you should expect to see it reflected. But how does Svelte know? You have to trace a lot of things. So Svelte does not know at all. It is too difficult to know. So that's why if you are updating a variable and this variable is not a state object, you just look at this statement, and if this statement, the object is not a state, this is not a state, then it will not kickstart an update cycle. Just so you know that we have already updated this data, but it's just not showing on the screen. I'm going to come over here. Have another function called do something else. And I'm going to, this time round, I'm going to say object.foo equals to 1. So calling this function will tell Svelte that object has updated and you need to go through and update the component. So if I have a button over here, says do something else. Something else. Right, so the point I want to show you is this. If I click increments a few times, the data, the object, the data is pointing the same object as the object. It's the same reference. So you should have already updated the count. The value has changed. But then Svelte does not know that it needs to update the component. So that's why you don't see this being reflected over here. But right now, if I come over here, I have a do something else, and this do something else assign one to the object, right? So it looks over here, object.foo, object is a state. So I'm gonna update my component. So if I click this right now, you see that it reflects immediately, right? It tells that object has updated. So it knows that you need to update all the element that relies on the object. It comes over here, it looks at object.count. Huh, what's the value right now? It is 11, so I need to update. So you see 11 reflected on the screen. But if you click again this, nothing happens. Because Svelte just look at this statement, it says data. Data is a state? No, okay, I can't do anything about it. Right, so this is something you need to know. You need to know this is a limitation of the Svelte's reactivity over here. Let's take a look at another example. This time around, we're gonna look at methods. For example, array methods. So calling a method. So if I have object as an array instead, okay, and I am going to call object.push, okay, so here I am going to say object.length, right? So every time when I call, I'm going to push one item in, and over here I should show the object length. I want to see the length of the object. But if I click, nothing happens. I think better is to just json.stringify so that you can have a better look at all the items, right? So I click, nothing happens. Again, object.push. Svelte has no idea you're calling a method, whether this method will affect this object itself. No idea at all. It could be just calling a function method and it does something else, like console log or do something else, right? It has no idea that this will affect object. So that's why it does not update everything. So if I come again to click at this something else, this will do an assignment, and assigning object tells that object has changed, and then hopefully Svelte will update this, right? So if I click here, see, it's updated because Svelte knows that, okay, you are updating object. So I come over here, object has changed, JSON stringify of object has changed, I reflect it on the screen. So now Svelte knows, right? So calling a method or update, or you assigning a reference to another variable and update that variable, Svelte has no idea that you are changing the state. So these are the few caveats of limitation of the Svelte's reactivity. Lastly, let me share you with a tip. This tip hopefully will help you to understand this whole reactivity better. So over here, Svelte will compile all this code into JavaScript. So let's take a look at the JavaScript output. Come over here, we scroll down, you would probably see this increment function, right? So everything that we've written is copied over here, right? It's nothing special. Well, nothing special is the problem. If you don't see anything different, then which means that when you try to change the variables over here, it does not trigger an update cycle. If we scroll down to look at the do something else, you see that something is different. You see this $ invalidate function. This function tells Svelte that, hey, update this object, and then also kickstart a new update cycle. So if I uncomment this, you see that in each statements that I said will kickstart an update cycle, you see that they all comes together with a $ invalidate. A well count does not, okay, that's because we count is no longer a state, right? So if I define count over here, you probably will see that, and to use it to show this count over here, you'll see that all of them will have the $ invalidate function being called alongside with them, because it knows that you are updating a state and this state is being used in your template. So go update, right? So all this has invalidates, but the case that I say, the caveat, the limitation does not have. So this, hopefully this little tips will help you to a better understanding how Svelte reactivity works. So try to write something on the left and take a look at the right and see whether Svelte picks it up at this $ invalidate function, and you know that whether this will kickstart an update cycle. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have anything that I explained not that well, you're not sure of, you want to ask me, comments down below. And lastly, subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next video is out. So see ya. Bye bye.